Good day. Today I'm going to upgrade my Jumper T16 and thought I'd take you along with me. Since Jumper came out with the T16, they've also come out with a series of upgrades, and now I'm happy to say the Jumper T16 upgrade list continues. The 2020 version of the T16 is coming out with internal battery charging and a handle that folds so it fits in your backpack more easily. These are nice features the new version will have, but Jumper hasn't left those of us out who purchased the previous version of the T16. So today, I'll show you how to do these upgrades, and I'm also going to ops check the new upgrade after install for you by powering it on, connecting to a flight simulator, and finally making sure the internal charging board actually charges the batteries. You know the drill. There's a hyperlinked table of contents for you in the video description below, which allows you to click on a timestamp and jump to that portion of the video. And as always, for your convenience, I've included links to all of the products and tools mentioned in this video, when they're available, in the description below as well. Remember, if you or someone you know is a rookie FPV pilot with less than a year's experience, or someone who wants to get started with FPV the right way, check out the Fast Track FPV course for your clear flight path to FPV fun. If you're ready to upgrade your Jumper T16 the easy way, give the video a thumbs up below, share it with someone who'll benefit from it, and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff. Okay, to begin with, the upgrades which will be available to you include the foldable handle, a new backplate for the multi-module bay, and the USB-C charging board. And here in just the next few minutes, I'll demonstrate the installation of each one of these features on your currently existing Jumper T16, which will upgrade your current Jumper T16 to the new 2020 version. The first thing I'm going to do to get it out of the way is upgrade the backplate for the multi-module bay. Take this out, this thick one, and we're going to stick this thin one in. Before we do, I'm going to weigh it, show you the added benefit of this plate. The old one comes in at 21 grams. New one comes in at 6 grams. We're saving 15 grams by doing this. Take the old one out. Snap the new one in. Done. Next, we'll install the USB-C charging board. In order to do that, of course, we're going to have to remove this back plate. I'll quickly show you how we're going to do that. Get into the battery bay and gently remove the battery. We're going to gently disconnect the battery. Now, this is where your SD card is as well. You can take that out or just be very careful when you remove the back plate. To remove the back plate, we take off these panels. They just pop right off. And you'll also want to remove these side panels, which just pop off like these other panels did. One, two. And now what you've got are six screws to remove. These two at the top, you have two at the sides. And you have two at the very bottom here, as well as here. You also have at the top these two hex screws that you have to undo and gently remove the antenna plate. Now, I'm going to save both you and me time by not showing you how to unscrew screws. But what I will show you is the toolkit, which I'm going to use to do it. This is called a Precision Pro toolkit. And the only reason I'm showing you this is it's got everything you need in it. It's got the hex drivers, it's got the flatheads, it's got the Phillips screws, it's even got a little magnifying glass. This is a good extension as well. This you can get through Harbor Freight for about $8 or through Amazon for about $14. And of course, I'll put the links for you down in the video description below. All right, screws are out. We gently take this off. Be careful because the antenna's attached. Then we just lift this back cover plate off gently. And whenever you remove or replace the back plate onto the transmitter, be careful not to bend these pins right here of the multi-module bay. And make sure that you place it over the battery connector here. And as I mentioned earlier, you can always remove the SD card or just make sure that the SD card fits in this slot here as well as the battery connector here. And of course, your pins, you want to make sure they fit in here when you put the backplate back on the transmitter. All right, this USB-C charging board upgrade kit comes with obviously the charging board. Now, I want to show you the difference between this USB-C connector and the one that comes with the T16. And here you can see the mini USB connector here and the USB-C connector here. And you can see the different shape, which means you're going to need to get a USB-C cable to go with the USB-C connector in order for you to be able to use it for both charging and flying on a simulator. And of course, the cable I purchased to go along with this USB-C connector, I'll go ahead and put a link to that in the video description below. The wiring harness that comes with the USB-C charging board has a connector that goes right there. And these three wires just get soldered up to this small board here, the power board. And you'll want the wires to be running from the power board over to the USB-C connector board, which we're going to install. So the way this is going to work is we're going to solder this red wire to this solder pad, the yellow wire to the middle solder pad, and the black wire to the solder pad here on the left of your screen, the negative solder pad. And they're labeled. The one on the right is positive, the one on the left is negative, and you want to put the yellow one in the middle. Now there's two ways we can do this. We can just leave this board in here and solder these wires to those pads, or we can disconnect this connector as well as the ribbon cable and take the board out and solder it that way. I'm going to go ahead and take the board out by disconnecting the ribbon cable and this connector, and we'll go from there. All right, so I'm going to remove this connector gently, just pull it right out. And then on this ribbon cable, there's a little latch right here. You just want to get your fingernail or something small underneath that and pop this up like that. And then this ribbon cable gently pulls right out like so. And now you've got the complete board out of the transmitter. Now what I'm going to do when I solder this is I use something called Blu-Tack. This gob right here, it just comes in these strips like so. And it's just a little handy thing that you can stick on your workbench. And I'm going to stick this over here like this. And all that does is it holds it in place while I'm trying to solder the wires onto the pads. So once again, we want the red wire on the positive, yellow wire in the middle, and black wire on the negative over here to the left. Let's go ahead and do that soldering. Now, as long as we're doing some soldering, I thought I'd do a quick little soldering tutorial. What I use for my solder is MG Chemicals 6337 ratio solder, 0.032 inches in diameter, and I'm going to tin my soldering iron, which I normally run at 475 degrees. I've got an adjustable solder temperature soldering iron. You can adjust the temperature just by pushing these buttons. I don't even know what brand it is. Model E60W CXG, it looks like. I just got this off of Amazon. But I normally run my soldering iron somewhere between 400 and 475, and I'm going to tin the soldering iron with this MG Chemicals 6337. I'm using a sponge here, clean it off. You always want to keep your soldering iron clean. And this solder, as well as the Blu-Tack, which I mentioned earlier, of course, I'll go ahead and put links to those in the video description below if you're interested in that as well. So let's go ahead and solder these wires on. And what I want to do is I want to grab my pliers and hold this. The ends of the wires have already come tinned, so I don't need to do that. So we're going to be careful not to mess with this ribbon cable. And we're going to put the red over here. Like so. And then the yellow. And then the black to the negative. All right, now that we have this wiring harness soldered on to the power board, we're just going to reinstall this power board into the slots, connect the power cable back here, and reconnect this ribbon cable back here. So let's insert this into the slots. Like so, plug in the power. Make sure it's fully connected.
Then we take this ribbon cable and gently insert this blue part back in there, making sure it's straight, and we just close this latch. All right, now we're ready to remove our old mini USB board. And the way we do that is there are two screws, one here and one here, both of which you do not see right now because I've already removed them to save time. The only thing I need to do now is to disconnect this ribbon cable from this board here. The reason I'm doing that is the new USB-C board comes with its own ribbon cable, which is already attached to the connector here, and it's just got the loose end of the ribbon cable going down here. So that's the reason I'm going to take this end of this ribbon cable out of this connector as opposed to this one. So to do that, once again, just like we did earlier, we pop this little gray latch up like so, and we pull this out, and I lift this up, and there's our old one. We're going to install the new one. The new one's going to go in, and the way we do that is we take this end of the ribbon cable, blue side up, insert it in here, and pull down the latch, and then we reinstall two screws, which I won't show on camera. So I'm going to gently insert this ribbon cable, making sure that it's straight, and I'm going to close this little gray latch. By pressing down on it, and there our ribbon cable is now seated inside this connector. Then we just reinsert the screws, one here and one on this other side. All right, now that we've got our new board installed with the two screws reinserted, all we need to do now is connect this wiring harness up to the new board through that connector. Before we do, these wires are sort of loose. What I like to do is hold one end of the wires down here where they're soldered and twist them a little bit just so that they're not running around loose, a little bit tighter. And then with the red wire on the right-hand side, insert the connector here. Now, this connector should only go in one way. I'm just, for demonstration purposes, letting you know that the red wire is going to be on the right-hand side. Red, right, both start with R. Red, right sounds like a football play. And we want to plug this in, like so. Make sure this antenna wire is underneath the USB-C board wire. And then what you want to do is tuck this wire in somewhere so it's not flopping around and getting caught up in anything to the best of your ability. That'll work. And we're all set. Now, before we put the back plate back on and reinstall everything, what I want to do is do the other upgrade, which is our new foldable handle. And it comes with these parts here, two hex screws and these. So you see this flat part here? So it fits in like this, sort of like a puzzle. It snaps in. And then you do the other side, another puzzle piece, snaps in like that. Here's the old handle. Underneath you have these two hex screws here and here. I'm going to take those out. That's the only thing holding this handle on, and remove the handle, and then we're going to place this handle on here. All right, we've removed the handle off the back just by loosening up these two screws, and we're going to reinstall this foldable handle. It says jumper here. So when we install it, jumper is going to go that way towards the outside. We take these holes, align them with the screws on the other side of this plate, and put it on. Now we have a foldable handle. And now we'll go ahead and put this back plate back on the Jumper T16. Okay, since I got my T16 back in October of 2019, it came with the cutout for the mini USB connector in the shape of the actual mini USB connector. This is actually the old board, which we just replaced, and this is the mini USB connector, and the cutout for it on this plate matched the shape of it. Well, now that we've got the USB-C connector installed in the T16, that connector is actually bigger than this cutout. So what we need to do is widen this cutout so that this plate will go over the USB-C connector. So this is the USB-C connector, and this is the cutout. This plate will not fit over this USB-C connector. So we just need to widen this, and I'm going to do that by burning these edges of this cutout with the soldering iron and just melt some of this material away so that this plate will fit over this USB-C connector. So now I've got a bigger hole here. Let's see if this plate fits over that USB-C connector. And now you can see that looks like it fits good. So I'm just going to reinsert the screws here and here, and we'll be all done. Now instead of putting that new backplate on, I've got a TBS Crossfire Lite module installed. And one of the things I was curious about is how would this foldable handle work with that? And you can see there's space between the bottom of the Crossfire module and the handle itself. So when you sit it down, the Crossfire module is not sitting on the ground. And then when you fold it back, the handle does rest on top of the Crossfire module, which is not a problem. Now there are three things I want to do for you to make sure that the new USB-C board that we installed actually works. I want to power it up, I want to check it out with a simulator, and I want to actually charge it using the USB-C charger. So first, let's make sure this thing powers up. That works good. All right, now what we're going to do is verify that the transmitter with the USB-C charging board installed actually works with our Velocidrone simulator. As you can see, I've got the USB-C cable connected to the T16, routed around to my USB hub with the hub turned on. So the transmitter is connected to the computer in game controller mode. And now we're just going to verify that I've got control of the quadcopter with the transmitter. And as you can see, the T16 is working fine with the new USB-C charging board along with the simulator. And now for the final test, we're going to see if this charging board actually charges the battery. You can see here we're starting out with one bar on the battery. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this transmitter off and plug the charger into the wall with it connected to the transmitter and see what happens. Plugging it into the wall. You can see the lights light up. That's a good sign. No smoke. I'm going to consider that a win. I'll come back later and see how much she's charged up. All right, let's see if this thing actually charged it. We're going to unplug it from the wall, turn it on, and take a look at the battery voltage. Looks like the internal charging board is working 100% as advertised. So let me know in the comments section below what you think of the new upgrades to the T16 and whether or not you'll be doing them yourself. If you want more good info on the T16, make sure to check out my Jumper T16 playlist and remember to visit the TMac FPV site for more free resources and to check out the exciting new Rattler Hybrid Micro FPV frame in the pilot stem page. Thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.